all the world's wars put together, First World, Second World War, Third World War, everything. Because the minute you take the drug, within a week, you take a muscle biopsy, you are first class, but take a muscle biopsy. Australian doctors have done this. Your muscle is already damaged. Whatever drug, cholesterol-lowering, all drugs are the same, cholesterol-lowering drugs. And we created this ghost called cholesterol. It's not a disease at all. That's why I said, more the merrier, I tell them. Higher your cholesterol, the better, because you will live longer. You will never get cancer. Of course, you will not have a heart attack. And if your cholesterol is below 300, you must be worried. This is the problem, because simply think for a little while. I want you to think for a little while without looking at the television, because television, you see, I was a very healthy man till the other day when I went to my doctor and I found cholesterol very high. I would have died. Now I am on X drug and I am very healthy. 100% untruth. Churchill said, advertisement is a legal way of lying. Did you get that? It's a legal way of lying. So that even Karthikeyan Saab can't arrest you, because you are legally right, but you are ethically wrong. Look at this week's Lancet magazine, one of the most prestigious medical magazines. The front cover says, although statins kill and produce diabetes in 1% out of 200, looking at the good that it does to the world, this is nothing. But you look at that very seriously. Look at the paper inside. Do you know what it says? If any country, people take this drug together, the incidence of new diabetes, mind you, you're not a diabetic, incidence of new diabetes goes up 10%. Which means, in the last 10 odd years that this drug has been in the market in India, it has produced 250,000 diabetics in this country. 2.5 lakhs of people. Then on the other side, there are a lot of researchers in Madras who every day make up a paper saying that whole of India will be eaten up by diabetes. Absolutely untrue. We are making diabetics. We are manufacturing diabetics by our drugs. Diabetes is not coming just like that. We manufacture. Every single drug that you take, except painkillers and aspirin, they increase your blood sugar. Every single drug is diabetogenic, of which cholesterol-lowering drugs are the biggest diabetogenic drugs. Now, very interesting thing comes. You look at this research paper in the Lancet. This is written by 8 quote-unquote thought leaders in America. Thought leaders. You know, they don't think. That's why they're called thought leaders. What did they write? They took a meta-analysis. They took 13 studies in this world, which included 4,35,000 human beings having taken this drug, okay, to see how many of them have worked on diabetes, etc., etc. That's not our concern now. I have told you what it is. But in the paper, you have to declare your conflict of interest. That is, when you write something, do you have any interest in that? Karthikeyan Saab understands that, because he is an authority on this. Now, very interesting. Front page says, conflict of interest, none, N-O-N-E in capitals. At the end of the article says, we are grateful to about 100 companies, of which all these assets are on the payload. They have shares. They are getting millions of dollars called lecture fees. You know, an ass like me, I go around lecturing, I get no fees. Maybe I'll get an airfare and a good hotel. These people get millions of dollars. You know, per day, I have gone to a meeting in London, which I came out because I didn't want to be a part of it. They promised £2,000 pocket money per day. Multiplied by 80, a first class suite in Dorchester Hotel, which is the most expensive hotel in UK. And up and down, for you and your spouse, first class fare. All that you have to do is write a nice paper saying that drinking a little alcohol is good for health. 7 of them took the bite and wrote it. And with that paper, the journal Heart wrote an editorial in 1981 January. Doctors now should go to society asking everyone to drink to prevent heart attacks. I wrote a letter to the editor in 1981 saying that this is wrong, the whole thing is a false thing, and you cooked it up. She didn't publish it. The editor didn't publish it. 2010, 3 months ago, the present editor of the British Medical Journal writes, there must be a ban on alcohol production and sale for human health. Then I wrote to her. I sent this old letter of mine and a new letter. She published both. Go to Ayurveda. Do you know what it says? People drink alcohol, varieties of alcohol, varieties of situations, in different seasons, different regions, with different foods. But one who does not want to be ill, unhealthy, should keep away from alcohol. Keep away from alcohol. What a beautiful advice. 15,000 years ago it was written. Now, the human body is not built with the idea that there will be these corporate hospitals, big doctors, tubes and scanners and things like that. No. You are built by whomever it is. If you believe in God, by God. If you don't believe in God, by nature. To live here as long as you can live. But don't you now go home with the idea that if you are having wellness and all, you will live here for 100 years. No, 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 no. You will certainly not succeed. You will die on the day you are supposed to die according to your genes. Nobody, nobody under the sun can even extend it by a second. But we doctors can advance it quite a lot. Which we have done. Which we have done. I have proof for that, if you want to know. We have advanced it a lot. But postponing, no. And lot of lay people, including medical doctors, have an idea that lifespan is equivalent to life expectancy. The two are totally different. Human lifespan is 120 to 140 years. Modern technology has brought it down now in America to 79 years. Can you understand that? But life expectancy is shown to go up. It's very simple statistics. This statistics is, you know what statistics is? Lice, super lice, and statistics. Lice are ordinary things which people like me talk. When the phone rings, if it is inconvenient, I tell my wife, say that he is eating. That's okay. No, you're not hurting anyone. Super lice are what politicians say. They'll promise a bridge where there is no river. They will solidify the air and they can make murder look very respectable. That's super lice. Then scientists have statistics. See, this study about this cholesterol lowering drug is called meta-analysis. Meta is afterwards, analysis. Study is done and published years ago. These people now reanalyze it and put them all together. 13 studies done in 13 different parts of the world under different conditions, entry criteria different, exit criteria different, the treatment different, human beings different, everything different. They mix them together, which I call as mix master technique. You know how it's done? You take bananas, apples, mangoes, oranges, sapotas, mix them in a big basket. Then put your hand there blindly, cover it, and take one fruit out and say, this is the representative of this basket. It may be a mango, but there is only one mango. Rest of it is all orange. You understand that? So it is absolutely foolish.